Greetings, Benjamin J. the Big Trouble Guy, with another in the series. What you're looking at is the Standard B bed plate that has been primered, and I just wanted to do a quick video before I proceed with anything else as far as painting it or doing anything else to it. Just wanted to do a video so you could see the result. All the rust is hidden, and this has got 6 coats of primer on it. This is black primer. And I like using black because usually whatever you're painting is black when it's an Edison phonograph. And that way if there's ever a defect or a scratch in the paint, you'll see the primer, which is also black. And when you do this, of course, I don't know if you can see this or not, but I've got little rolls of paper inside all of the holes to keep the paint out. And there's a rolled up piece of paper through the mandrel or through the stanchion for the mandrel. There's tape covering the stanchion for the end gate, and then there's little pieces of paper down in the holes to keep all the paint out. And I've covered the knife edge with a piece of tape and then trimmed it with a razor knife to keep all the paint off of the knife edge. And of course, when you peel that off, if there's any paint on it, you can just scrape it with a razor knife or a razor blade. But it keeps most of the junk off of the machine. And there's a little flaw right there. So another 2 coats of primer over that. So little by little, it's coming together. In the last 24 hours, this machine has changed dramatically. And it was in really, really terrible condition. And this is a really great way to experiment. You know, because if you don't like the color that you're going to paint it, you can always strip it again. And when you have a machine that was as bad as this one is, you can't do any damage. I mean, all you can do is improve it. And so in this case, just a few more coats of primer, and you can see how most of the pitting is gone. It's all filled in with primer. There's still a few glitches in the paint, like that one right there. But another spray or so, that'll take care of that. And once the primer is dried 24 hours, then I'll proceed with painting it. And like I said, I just wanted to do a quick video so you can see the progress. This has all been stripped and primed today. So it's not a time-consuming process. You can have, if you have all your parts laid out, you can have the machine disassembled, primered, or stripped, primered, and repainted virtually in one day. The only limiting factor is how quickly the paint is going to dry. And then I'm going to, after it's painted, I will let it set for one full day before I begin reassembling it. But in the meantime, just want you to see the progress. So a few more coats of this primer, and we can proceed with painting. So just a quick video on the bed plate itself. Dramatic improvement from what it was. As I said, most of the pitting has been filled in with the primer. I'll have to do some more spraying just to make sure. I mean, a lot of the stuff was really, really deep. And it's filling in nicely. A few more coats, and this is going to be a really, really nice-looking phonograph when it's finished. So the next step, of course, will be finishing the priming and then doing the painting. So as always, if you have any questions or comments, feel free to drop me an email, thevictrolaguy@gmail.com. Again, if you're going to be using the stripper, make sure you wear gloves and goggles. As far as painting it, once you have it stripped, it just depends on what color you want it to be and how much work you're willing to put into it as to what kind of result you're going to get. So it's not time consuming, it's not difficult. Anyone can do this, and this is all being done with spray paint. So I'll be spraying it with spray paint as well. So the next day or so, you're going to see a dramatic improvement in this Edison phonograph. So as always, if you have any questions or comments, please feel free to drop me an email, thevictrolaguy@gmail.com. And as always, thanks for watching.